Action. The theme of my presentation is Corona Crisis and the Economic Policy of the Bolsonaro Government. Next, please. I divided my presentation in five blocks. First, I will quickly review the economic policies before the Brazilian economy before the Corona Crisis. And after that, I will analyze the effects of the Corona Crisis on the Brazilian economy and the counter-cycle policies implemented by the government. And finally, I will conclude my presentation and show some perspectives for the Brazilian economy, please. Yes, next. Well, let me have a quick focus on the Brazilian economy before the Corona crisis. Since 2016, after the impeachment of the President Rousseff, there was a rude shift in the economic policy in Brazil toward a more orthodox and liberal approach. The liberal reforms implemented since then included the implementation of the constitutional expenditure ceiling in December 2016. That means a real freeze on government primary spending for 20 years as the public spending is readjusted by the previous year inflation. That means that there is no real growth in terms of the expenditure for 20 years. And secondly, it was also approved the labor reform in November 2017 that flexibilized the labor market in Brazil, including the implementation of temporary contract, intermittent work, the possibility of the workday of 12 hours, etc. And finally, the pension reform was approved more recently by the Brazilian Congress. That's among other measures, approved the increase of the minimum retirement age, increase of the minimum contribution time, among other measures. The government's promise was of greater economy growth due to the liberal reforms. This is what Krugman co called as the confidence fairy. Some confidence fairy would going to act in the Brazilian economy so that we could have more sustainable growth. Next, please. However, the economic growth disappointed, even though deep reforms were implemented in the Brazilian economy. As we can see in the figure, the GDP growth, the average GDP growth between 2017 to 2019 was only 1.3%. That means, in terms of per capita income, 0.5%. So that means that the Brazilian economy before the Corona crisis was virtually stagnating. And this is important because of the for the implementation of emergent and counter-cycle policies. Next, please. Well, as we can see here in this slide, we have the employment rate and discouraged people. Discouraged people includes working force that are not working, are not looking for work because they think that they will not get a proper work. Well, as we can see, the discouraged people has increased sharply recently, mainly after the labor reform. And in particular, we can see that we said that in the change from the first quarter 2020 to the second quarter of 2020, a huge increase of both unemployment rates and discouraged people. That means from 16.4% to 19.1%. So this is a huge, and this is very related how precarized was the labor market in Brazil before the corona crisis. Next, please. Well, I think that José Antonio showed with very a lot of detail the movement of capital flows to Latin America is just to show that Brazil was affected. The most direct channel of the corona crisis was the portfolio liabilities outflows. Was the portfolio liabilities outflows. And because of the presence of non-residents in currency denominated, domestic currency denominated assets. So in what the some BIS economists call the as original sin redux, that is a new form of external vulnerability that is related to the presence of non-residents in domestic markets with positions with domestic currency denominated assets. Next, please. Well, as we can see, however, that when we compare the exchange rates of Brazil to other emergent markets, you see that the Brazilian currency devaluated much more than other currencies. And the volatility of the exchange rate also increased during this period of the corona crisis to currently. Next, please. However, it would be expected to have the effect of the pass-through of exchange rates to the domestic price, but this did not happen, mainly because of the, as I showed before, the economy was stagnated before with the idle, enormous idle capacity of productive sector in Brazil for the crisis. And of course, after the crisis, this increasing greatly. And so we have the situation that the inflation rate measured by the consumer price index has been much lower than the inflation target for 2020, that is 4% per annum. So we have we are relatively comfortable about this price movements concern. Next, please. Well, the price was very, as José Antonio showed, that in Latin America, we could feel directly the spread of the corona crisis, and this was very strong on the Brazilian economy, mostly after March and the second quarter of 2020, in case of with a huge reduction for the industry and the services. The agriculture maintained growth mainly because of the performance of the commodities quarter. Next, please. So, let me focus what I call the political economy of the counter-cycle policy that shows ambiguous behaviors. This is a matter for more for political scientists than for economists, but it's necessary to focus this. That is the first reaction after the corona rising in first beginning of the March of the Minister of the Economy, Paulo Guedes, was that reforms is the best answer to the coronavirus crisis. For Guedes, there is only magic medicine for whatever economic problem. Liberal reform. Only medicine for everything. However, after the impacts, huge impacts, immediate impacts of the corona crisis, the government began to implement measures without fiscal policy, such as the postponement of tax, advance of payment of 13 wage to retirees, and so on. After that, the crisis continues very strong. And the President Bolsonaro first proposed the suspension of employment contract without any payment of wage, any payment of wage. And in December, because of the enormous political pressure, he proposed some income compensation to reduction of working hours and wage. Also, there was this sort of political economy in terms of approval of the emergent aid. That President Bolsonaro first proposed emergent aid of only R$200, that is $36, for 3 months, while the National Congress increased the emergent aid to R$500, that is equivalent of $19. Finally, the president tensioned the aid by R$600. Next, please. Well, as you know, the implementation of emergent and counter-cycle policies needs two necessary actions. The first is social protection measures, including income replacement for low-income people. This was very important in case of Brazil because of the increase of the employment and discourage people more recently in Brazil. Company relief measures, federal government financial support for states and municipalities, greater resource for public health system. Let's have a look on it. Please, next. As for fiscal measures, the Congress declared a state of public calamity on March 20, lifting the government obligation to comply with the primary balance targets and the constitutional expenditure ceiling, allowing to implement what was known as war budgets for 2020. Temporary income support to vulnerable households, as I mentioned, was approved, a monthly cash transfer of R$100 for 5 months, half of minimum monthly salary, more or less, to more than 50 million of beneficiaries that include unemployment, self-employment, and so on. This monthly cash transfer was reduced to R$300 for October, November, December, and will finish in the end of the year. Government special compensation of reduction of salaries to workers were also implemented, with contracts are temporarily suspended or cutting working hours until 70%. So it was allowed to reduce the working hours until 70%, and the government implemented with the unemployment program fund partial compensation for this. And finally, the transfer of R$79 billion from federal government to state and municipality government for the higher health spending and to cushion the expected fall in the revenues of these governments, that they cannot, they can, they are forbidden to issue public securities. Only federal government can do it. Next, please. Well, we can see in the, I will not explore this table, but it's just to show you that when we focus the main government expenditure with COVID-19, this is very recent data, that's almost 8% of the planning expenditure were already paid. So this is there are some criticism of some analysts that the government was delaying the disbursement of the expenditure, but recent figures show that it's almost 8% that has already been paid for emergent aid, especially of Bolsa Família, emergential benefits to maintenance of employment, emergency aid to state municipalities, financing program of payroll, payment. I will talk about this in the sequence, and quotas of credit guarantor funds. Next, please. Well, and also the fiscal impulse, the fiscal response of the Brazilian government to the COVID-19 compared to other emergent markets was not so bad. But indeed, Brazil was one of the mostly greater fiscal expenditure, in also in terms of the equity laws and guarantees that we're focusing in the second. So there was really a very active fiscal policy. Next, please. Well, let me focus now on the monetary and macro-financial measures. There are a lot of measures implemented for Central Bank of Brazil that was very active in most field was very active. First, the reduction in the policy rate from 4.25% in February 2020 to historical low of 2% in August 2020. Also, there are a lot of implemented measures to increase liquidity in the financial system, including the reduction of reserve requirements and capital conservation buffers, implementation of temporary relaxation of provisioning rules, etc. So there is a real increase in liquidity in terms of our financial system in Brazil that avoids a liquidity crisis, but not allowed an increase in the credit supply that we'll discuss in the sequence. Central Bank also was allowed to buy public-private bonds in the secondary market in order to affect the yield curve, in particular long-term rates. But until now, they are not making use of this exceptional power, and the spreads, I think that Jose Antonio has showed, the spread in general are increasing. Brazil and the government is not, the central bank is not doing anything about this. But he could interview and in order to flatten the yield curve. Well, finally, there is the implementation of new line of direct credits with injection of treasury resource that includes a program called PESI, to finance payroll until 2 minimum wage of small firms during 4 months with obligation to maintain the workers' employment for the same period. And also two other programs, PRONAMP and PIAC, for small and middle firms that are supported by guarantor funds that provides default hedging for banks. Next, please. Next, please. Well, as we can see, this is the rate of growth of corporate credit stock. That is the blue is the small firms, and the orange is the big firms. We can see that it was only in July that increased the corporate credit for small and middle firms. Until there was very low growth for this segment. So there is a sort of credit rationing for small and middle firms. But there is a lot of concern about this because they are very labor intensive. So it was only with the guarantor funds of credit were in place that the banks began to offer credit for small and middle firms. And the PESI, that is the special program for payroll payroll of the firms did not succeed. Only 70% of the total available until October 2020 was used. And this was for a lot of reasons. One is a lot of bureaucracy involved in this line of credit, and also because the credit was only to pay the wages. It was directly deposited in the bank account of the workers. And during the crisis, the people want to be free to apply whatever they want. Next, please. And as for, because of the emergent aid that reached 52 million beneficiaries in Brazil, that was 25 of the total of population in July 2020, we can see that this program had, and Merrick mentioned this, about Brazil, that it was very strong effect in terms of social inequality and the reduction of the poverty in Brazil. As we can, the figures are very clear in this sense. As we can see, the people that earn less than half of minimum salary, just looking at 2019, July 2020, August 2020, we see that the reduction was very quickly and strong, for 31 to 23.7%. And of course, the other segment, the follow segment, increased consequently in the same period. Next, please. And the same happened in terms of the reduction of poverty and extreme poverty, that was very strong. The reduction from May 2020 to July and August 2020. That was a huge reduction in terms of poverty, 24% of the population to 8.4% in August 2020. Next, please. Well, finally, I think this is the last figure that I will show. We can see that there is, after the huge decline of the economy in March and April of this year, the economy recovered mainly after June. That was the culmination of the relaxation of the measures, and also the implementation of this aid program for people, and finally the fact that there was no credit crunch in Brazil. So it was, the central bank was succeed in terms of avoid any liquidity problem and even a credit crunch in Brazil. Next, please. Well, I conclude that, as I mentioned, that the economy recovered, it was this combination and of relaxation of social distance, the opening of domestic trade that eventually can be a problem if we are going to have a second wave of coronavirus. Also the emergent aid program and no credit rationing, mainly due to the guarantee of credit fund, implementation of guarantee credit fund, because it's not, when central bank in the beginning checked a lot of liquidity in the banking sector, but the banks, the premium risk of the banks was very, very, very high, so they did not provide, mainly for small size firms. There was a very strong rational credit for this segment of the firms. That it was only with guaranteed credit funds that it relaxed this sort of problem. emergency aid contributes not only to avoid income losses, but indeed increases the income of more vulnerable segments of population, reduces poverty and social inequality in a very short period of time. It is important to understand that this was not a previous expected result of ad hoc measures, as they were implemented according to the circumstances and mainly political pressures, including by the National Congress. It was not a planned intervention of the government that we know that is negationist about the coronavirus problem spread in Brazil. But it was the circumstance, political pressure of the Congress, mainly by the Congress, that implemented this broad range of countercyclical and emergent measures, in general, greater than other Latin American. However, unemployment and informal work increased dramatically during the coronavirus in Brazil, and still is very high, and they are a real concern for the next future. There is a lot of concern about this. There is the phenomenon that is known in the literature as the Easter eggs, that's the permanence after a long time of the problem of something that is happening. That is in the case is unemployment. Uncertain about the future of the Brazilian economy is very rude, and this is one of the reasons that is the uncertainty is not about the economy, but also about political issues in Brazil. That is very, very dramatically. There is no, but in terms of the economy, there is no government strategy to implement agenda for a sustainable growth. For instance, there is no government, any government program oriented to invest in infrastructure. So the economy reacts, or more or less reacts, the counter-cycle policy, emergency policy. There is this effect of reduction of the inequality because the bottom of the pyramid decrease less than the other segments of the pyramid. This is what you have this movement. But the problem, the main problem, current problem, is that the government don't have a long-term strategy for a sustainable growth in Brazil. The strategy is of the government is what I call return of the old normal. That means return of the constitutional expenditure ceiling for 2021. There is a normal pressure of the market, financial market in Brazil to maintain the ceiling. And a new round of reforms, including administrative reform, privatization. However, I have to say this agenda has already proven to be a formula for failure. Thank you.